In honor of the entrance, everybody stands.
Sixty-seven members of the dance group traveled here from Vancouver. It's quite the trek.
Yes, 67, plus they picked up the locals here and the locals from Lac-Vallée. Understand that this whole gymnasium has been sold out for this event, Kiefer.
Yeah, we're at a capacity crowd. Everyone showing lots of respect. That the temperature's coming up, but you can feel the spirits rising every time they beat their drums. It's amazing.
Yes.
I'm starting to get goosebumps.
So this gymnasium is not a gymnasium this evening. For this special event, it's called the Big House.
The Big House. My apologies. The Big House is it's full, and it's awesome. You know what, William? This makes me miss Gatuas and Bella Bella. You get the same kind of feeling.
Good to see this many people participating, especially in the GMCN locals. They're always a splinter group that shows up, but combining all the locals from Vancouver, Rupert and Lac-Vallée, it's good to see this.
Yeah, there's definitely a lot of dancers. Their sound is filling the house right now.
And now it's a treat in the opening ceremonies, no matter what nation is putting it on, to see all the kids and the mothers carrying the little babies too.
Yeah, that's the beautiful thing about culture. It's similar in so many ways, but yet unique in a million different ways as well.
That's right.
And all very powerful. Again, the energy in the room is just immense. You can just feel it.
Too bad they didn't ask our sisters from across Alaska to come down and help participate. Because a lot of the Metlakatla Alaska are from Lac-Vallée and Metlakatla, BC, too.
Oh, okay.
I understand that Metlakatla is hooked up for this tournament again, Kiefer, so we want a big set out to Taekwon of Alaska.
Metlakatla will be playing tomorrow morning, 8 a.m. against Port Simpson in the intermediate division. Should be a great game.
Also, a big shout out to the Haisla Nation, Yotes. I understand they got their power back on earlier this evening.
Yes, it's so great to hear. I mean, Terrace and Kitimat area just got dumped on with all that snow and people without power for a long time. It's tough to live like that. Check out all the action on the live stream at www.cfnrfm.com. But if you can't see this, I suggest you check out our website and see exactly what's going on down here in Prince Rupert right now, because this is awesome.
And the cheering is the dancers are leading in the big chiefs from the four different crests of the MCN Nation. With the chiefs are the matriarchs. The chiefs that are leading the other chiefs in are the chiefs from this territory where Rupert is in the Jim Simone Civic Center. And the chiefs bowing to the crowd in acknowledgement, and they get it back. And that's the house I belong to right here. Our MP Nathan Cullen. And our MLA.
Jennifer Rice. Jennifer accompanying Rice. Him. Nice to see them supporting the games. They were here last year, they're here this year. I always try to get out which team they're rooting for, but they never tell me. They're rooting for everybody.
Really diplomatic, eh?
See, well, this is what I love about the All-Native. I mean, we're here for a basketball tournament, but we get to be a part of such cultural events like this.
Yeah.
It's truly something special.
Guy checking out his phone. The guy in the white?
Yeah.
That make a difference?
Yeah, it's starting to pick up and get louder in here, definitely.
That's right.
It's so amazing to see the age range of the dancers from the youngest to the eldest.
Yeah.
You know,
even though he didn't have a headdress on, but he's got down on his hair, in his hair.
Gotta represent, Will. You gotta represent.
Right. That's cool.
You know, I was a little bit tired after the long day today. Now I'm feeling super energetic.
Thank you.
Well, for a second, I almost forgot I had a headset on. I almost started wooing around. Woo. That was awesome.
I think at one point tonight, Kiefer, we're going to see the repatriation of a song from the Haida Nation to the Tsimshian Nation.
Yeah, again, it's a beautiful thing, and we're practicing culture here again at the All-Native Basketball Tournament, where we get to practice our ceremonies now. So it's just, it's such a modern adoption of culture that I just, you know, I'm just in love with it. I love the All-Native. I had trouble sleeping last night because I was so excited to get here.
Well, looking at the walls, Kiefer, just some people haven't been to the Russell Gamble Gymnasium. That's his picture above the CFNR banner.
Mm-hmm.
Russell Gamble from Kitkatla, an all-star Hall of Famer basketball player, but also so many years on the All-Native Tournament Committee. That's why the gymnasium's named after him.
Yeah, I talked to Eva Spencer, the vice president. She said the reason she got into this was because of Russell Gamble. So he started something amazing, and people are just continuing on with the legacy.
Now they're going to bring in the team.
Oh. Teams are entering now.
Vancouver coming in.
Starting off with the Vancouver squad. Vancouver ladies, Vancouver senior men.
Vancouver men's. Here comes Lacroix Lamb's players.
A lot of Lacroix Lamb's fans in the house. Now the energy is picking up, William.
Yeah. Lacroix Lamb's intermediates.
Metlakatla teams entering.
Tigra, Metlakatla BC women's.
Welcoming back the Metlakatla Alaska Intermediates to the tournament. In come the Prince Rupert Rain, ladies
team.
That's
what people come here for, Kiefer, is to see the margin of all the different teams.
Thank you.
And it's good to see the players shaking the hands of all the chiefs and matriarchs.
It's a great gesture. Prince Rupert Sr. is entering. Kikala Intermediates and Kikala Seniors, Kikala Women entering the building. Cheers from the rafters.
Kikala Masters, Intermediates, Kikala Women's. Hartley Bay Intermediates. Hartley Bay Intermediates passing the podium. Terrace Seniors. Colith Intermediates.
Village of Gingol coming in.
Terrace Wex has passed the podium. The Sons of Gingol.
Gingol Master.
Intermediate team passing the podium. Kinkola Seniors. Kinkola Seniors. Greenville Seniors. Greenville Masters. Silk Women's. Thank you. good exercise for the dancers and singers.
Yeah, they're going to have to go 45 minutes straight, their dance leader was saying. So they've been practicing singing hard for a long time, and they're doing a great job so far.
Kitlin Silk Masters. Kitlin Silk Seniors. New Orleans women coming in. And they just announced the New Orleans Seniors. Comes your team. Massett.
Oh, the old Massett Intermediates entering the building. My boys in red and black. Yeah, I got the chance to coach a lot of these kids as they were growing up, so it's really awesome to see them here playing in the All-Native Basketball Tournament.
Masters just passing the podium. Massett women's coming on.
Hey guys.
Yeah.
Craig, we can barely hear you and we can't hear each other.
Yeah, I hope you don't mind if I jump in for a second here.
What's that?
I want to let the folks know
can you
who
hear
are
Craig?
Listening.
I can't hear you.
And yep. Trying to watch online that that's okay. I just want to let the folks know that those who are trying to watch online, what's causing the slowdown is a pre-roll ad. So if you just be patient and wait for that spinning circle, eventually it will end and then you'll get to the streaming. So I'll just let you guys carry on with the broadcast here.
Are we on break right now?
Nope. Carry on.
Massett Seniors just went by. Now we got the Massett Masters moving by.
So folks at home on trying to get on the live stream, just be patient, wait it out, good things will happen.
Hazleton Skittigat is going by us.
Yeah, they're coming back to try to repeat their efforts from last year. Jesse Barnes and the crew are ready to get it done.
It's good to see the Stoney sisters back in the Hazleton lineup.
Yeah.
One of them was battling cancer for a while.
They're always a strong team, and they're looking especially strong this year. I'm excited to see them play. Crowd warming up to the old Massett Masters busting into dance.
Kidney Owl Seniors. Oh, Samoa Lawrence Hydesums. Good nail. Kitimat women's going by. Kitimat seniors going by.
They're looking very strong this year. The return of Darren Metz.
Kitimat Masters. Bella Bella Women's.
Bella Bella Senior.
Bella Bella Masters. A big shout out to the Grant family out in Heisman country, Kitimat. One of their masters is down in Vancouver having tests done. So our prayers are with you and hope things work out. To Alex Grant. Bella Bella Intermediates going by. Bella Bella Seniors coming up. Bella Bella Seniors. Bella Coola Women. How's it, seniors? Hesquit Women. And I think we're rounding out the teams to come in. Kamloops Women are the last team to enter the gymnasium.
So great to see the Kamloops team up here this year for the All-Native Tournament.
Yeah.
They had to go through qualifying. They made it. Now they're here for the big show. They got their first win this morning. I think the Kamloops women team is the last team to enter the building.
Yeah, they're coming in there now.
And you're right. It is a tight fit out there for all the players and the fans. This is a amazing energy. I can't describe it. They sang for a long time, William, and they did an amazing job.
Yeah.
That was 100% the whole way. Then they went 120 to finish.
Minutes from start to now.
That's a long time to sing.
A long time.
I think if people are having an issue checking the live stream, I think they should just search the hashtag CFNR, and you're definitely going to find some great stuff. Or the All-Native Basketball Tournament, you'll also find some stuff. All you have to do is type that in, and you'll find out what's going on here.
Good evening. On behalf of the All-Native Tournament Board, we'd like to welcome all Chiefs and Maker, special guests, dignitaries, players, and fans.
This is Willis Parnell, one of the MCs.
All the players into the gym. We had a great start to the tournament, first four games by the ladies today. Start full day tomorrow, 8 in the morning. On behalf of the board, we'd like to say to all teams, players, and for the fans, for spirited play, hard play, and with a lot of respect to each other, to the referees, may you all have a great week and have some great cheering, and of course be very loud for your teams and enjoy all the great basketball that's going to happen.
That was Willis Parnell, Hall of Famer on the CFNR crew, playing with the old Mass at Masters again this year. Said he wanted to finish out his career playing against the Dincha.
Fred Spencer going back. He's the Master of Ceremonies right now.
Kill him. Shim Kiket. Lucky Kiket. Shigeta Manak. Kaba Wild. I'd like to take this opportunity to welcome you unto the land of my people, the Manhattan-Gajee's House of Blue. The name of this place where this building is situated on, and very good to name, is called Wulyeh Medir, which means where the grizzly bear walks. And the reference grizzly bear is the main crest of my house. I don't have it on right now. I'm using my Manhattan crest. And I'd like to welcome you all. Feel free to come and go as you please. Enjoy everything that you need to. And to wish you all to be safe. And I'd like to give a special welcome to the players from the Linton. I spent 8 years of my life in the Indian Residential School in Linton, B.C. So you're going to have me to be your cheerleader. Thank you. I'd like to extend a special thank you to Christine Martin for inviting us to take part in the opening of this all-native tournament. Thank you, Christine. I really appreciate that. And I want to thank Peter Hagen, as well as his committee and board, for arranging this tournament. And as always, I know they've done a really good job, and they always will do that as long as we continue to have this all-native tournament. Thank you, Peter, and your crew. And my people, wish you all the luck in the world. And we know you're going to do your best. And that's what makes us proud of our people, to see them overextend themselves to try to win tournament. But remember, you don't have to win to be proud of yourself. The way you make you proud of yourself is to keep on going until the final whistle at the end of the game. Then you'll see later that you will be proud of it. With that, I wish you all a very good night. Enjoy all the games. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Jones. And now speaking on that Pico Jones strike, Smog and Yon, the speaker will be Lenny Bryant. Thank you, Master Summary.
Kenny Brank speaking.
Speaking on behalf of my smoig, Jan, standing with the talking stick. Welcome the teams to the tournament this year. Before I start speaking, before we came out, we had some sad news of the passing of a lady in our Simshian Nation. I'd like to ask everybody to have a moment of silence, not just for her, but for everybody. Tsimshian Nation that has passed in the last year. Could we have a moment of silence, please? Thank you very much. It's good to see the crowd out here tonight. We honor to all these teams out here that came in this evening to sponsor of their communities. And for this dance group that came from Vancouver and who extended their welcome to other dance groups from the Tsimshian Nation, put on a very good show this evening. Very entertaining. Thank you, Bill and Josh. Thank you very much for the entertainment and for everything that you guys did coming in this evening. And to the teams, we wish you all luck this evening and all through the week. We hope you have good success and whoever comes out on top. The best man or lady team win this, all this week. And the people that came up, all the people that came out from all over the villages to support their team, the band. All the chiefs that you see sitting in the front seats. Ladies of high esteem, matriarchs. Thank you all for coming out. Fans that are going to be here all week. We hope you enjoy your week. Thank you again for the good yards. My luck.
First one that didn't try to speak
like to
our language from the end.
To the 2015 All-Native Basketball Tournament.
Sticking to what he knows, doing a good job.
I just want to share a quick story. When I was a teenager at Prince Rupert, I worked with Aboriginal youth. And I was a summer camp leader. And one summer, we were walking to the Civic Center. And I was talking to one young boy named Zach when he was 7 years old. And I asked him, Zach, what is your favorite part about going to the Civic Center? He said, you know, I like playing basketball. And I said, oh, well, what is it about basketball? He said, well, my older brother plays basketball. I was like, oh, yeah. He's like, yeah, and he plays in the All-Native Basketball Tournament. And I said, well, what is it about the All-Native Basketball Tournament that you like? And honestly, with a smile on his face, as a matter of fact, said, because that's where my people gather.
He's not wrong.
I'll never forget that, and that just came to my mind when I was having to talk to you all today. So I just want to welcome all the chiefs and matriarchs, the elders, all the players, all the teams, their families from all the nations from far and wide who have come here. I know firsthand what this tournament is, how important it is for our community, and how this is a tradition that's actually been going on longer than I've been alive. So welcome everybody. Thank you to the organizers and sponsors, and play hard and know that we've all won because we keep gathering here every year. Thank you.
The mayor of Prince Rupert.
Member of Parliament Nathan Cullen coming up.
Now we're going to hear some Somali.
It is an honor to be with you here tonight. Thank you to the Chiefs Matriarchs for allowing me and my colleagues to walk in with you. It is a feeling for me when those drums start up. I think it takes us back to old times. That Christine Martin, that voice. Woo! I want to borrow that voice. I could use that voice in Parliament. Maybe she needs to be in Canada's Parliament.
Oh, yes.
That is the voice of authority. To all the teams, welcome. So good to see my friends from Kitimat. I'm glad you made it out of the snow. My God. I was asked to do two things tonight. One, I've already broken already, was keep it short. The other one was no politics, unless I came here to promise a new floor for the tournament. So, here's the deal. I'm a bit upset with you all because every year I come here, and some of the nannies, the elders say, we got something to fix that baldness thing you got there. We'll get you some bear grease, and here I am back again. So you guys help me fix this problem, and I'll help you fix this problem, okay? Is that a deal? Let's get some government money in here. Let's get some private money to get you guys a proper floor next year. What do you say?
Well, Nathan Cullen promising a new floor if we get him here. I don't know how that's going to work. I think we got a better chance of getting a new floor there, William.
That's right.
Jennifer Rice.
Jennifer Rice, our MLA.
A member of the Legislative Assembly.
What did I do this year?
A little bit.
There you go. William, I knew you were waiting for that.
I was told I really messed it up last year.
Shots fired.
Thank you. I just came back from Bella Bella yesterday. And I was trying to actually make it over to Clem 2 before I hopped on the ferry. But it's unfortunate that, again, the weather, which we all know in the North Coast here, in the Northwest, that prevents us from getting around easily. And well, I just want to say I had a fun time on the ferry. The ferry, I think half of the Central Coast or most of the Central Coast population was on the boat, so I could have just ridden the ferry to reach out and talk to people. Thank you for the conversation. I just wanted to do a shout out to Archie Robinson, who is, I hope he's here. Is he here tonight? I wanted to just let him know that I promised to bring him 2 basketballs in April, and I hope that helps bring Clem 2 team here next year.
Kidasu.
And la- lastly, I don't want to break too many rules, but speaking about the voice of authority, I was very impressed to see how many women ball players we have here tonight. Shout out to the women. It would be fantastic for us to see more women participating in basketball, more voices of authority in Parliament, and more of those voices of authority in the legislature where I'm going tomorrow and will be sitting for the next 11 weeks. Thank you, everyone. Have a good game. Good bunch of games. Enjoy.
Jennifer Rice.
Our Emily, Jennifer Rice.
Thank you, Jennifer. And now for the teams to exit.
And after a nice little brief rest, the dancers will get up and start drumming and singing again. Kamloops player gave one of the Chiefs that said he can be a cheerleader, give him a top.
Now he really gets to cheer for the Kamloops Suns. Yeah. Two ends. Yeah, and if you guys have time tomorrow night, check out the Nishka Marching Band. They'll be playing at the PAC Leicester Center tomorrow night at 6 p.m. That's the Nishka United Marching Band. And here we go at the exit of the players. Oh, and the energy picks up just like that.
And the spectators are starting to stand again.
Thank you.
good to see them proudly waving the flags.
Yeah, I imagine everyone's going to home and get some rest because we got a lot of basketball tomorrow.
Like his tunic, wearing a nice tunic. You should have put yours on today.
If I knew, I should have. That was Mikey Russ's tunic, a young Haida warrior from the Haida Nation.
Terrace has a pretty big team.
Yeah, they've been doing a lot of work. They have a league going on up in Terrace, and I was really surprised at the level of competition that they had. Terrace Wax.
I like their name too, Terrace Wax.
The Wax. I am now a resident of Terrace, so I'm going to throw them a couple cheers for the hometown boys. All the Tsimshian teams left on the court, on the dance floor, representing extremely well. This is so awesome.
That's spontaneous, huh?
You can't explain the feeling you get when moments like that happen.
Yeah.
I'm not only proud to be Haida, I'm proud to be First Nations, and I'm proud to be in this area with these people. You know,
the best place in the world is right here, right now.
Here it is. It's happening. I was a little kid listening to this, and now here I am on the radio with Wild William Wesley. Life is good.
Teams have exited the Russell Gandel Gymnasium, the 56th annual All New Basketball Tournament. The final words will be said now.
Hello. Okay, tonight I'd like to thank the Tim Sand dancers for doing a good job.
First Nation Health Authority for bringing me out here to come and speak to you guys and see all these beautiful things. decided I was on up here. If you told me all these things.
Okay, headphones off, guys. Okay, we're back. Okay, you guys?
Yeah.
Are you there?
I could hear you.
I can hear you.
Okay, how come I can barely hear you guys? Say something. Hello? Kiefer?
Sorry, Craig, still can't. I can't hear you over the drumming.
What about now? Hello?
Hello?
Are you guys ready?
I could hear Jesse a bit.
Say again? Kiefer? Kiefer? Hello?
Hello? William, can you hear them?
I can't hear anything.
What the hell, man? Can you guys hear me? Hello?
Hello?
Talk to me?
Okay, that's better.
What the hell?
Still having trouble hearing you, though, Craig.
You're having trouble hearing me?
Yes.
Okay.
And we can't hear each other.
Yeah. I don't know what it is. Something to do with this thing. Can you guys hear each other now?
I could hear you.
Yeah, I can hear you. Now I can hear William a lot better.
Can you hear, you can hear each other?
Yeah, I could hear him.
Yeah, it sounds a lot, it's kind of fuzzy, but it sounds good now.
Yeah.
Okay, I'll just drop it down a little more. Okay, keep talking.
It's the opening ceremonies. They're doing the masked dance, Tsimshian Nation and Lochkeen dancers from Vancouver.
Okay, yeah. Jesse.
They just got through. They're still performing the Raven Dance.
Can you hear me, Jesse?
To the people on the live stream, we, of course, experiencing some technical difficulties.
Jesse, can you hear me? Yeah, you're kind of muffled, but.
And welcome back to the 56th Annual All-Native Basketball Tournament opening ceremonies. We just witnessed the Raven Dance by the Lochkeen dancers from Vancouver, Lech Walams and Prince Rupert, in honor of her uncle, who is just starting to take his seat now with all the other chiefs. And the crowd still here at the, enjoying a great performance put on by these dancers.
Yeah, it's been a great night. The team's exited. Now sets the stage for the Lockheed dancers. They got a lot of the young children out on the floor right now.
And what an inspirational speech by the basketball player that you had a chance to interview.
Yeah, Damon Bell-Holter just before this, great words of wisdom on his way back to the NBA.
First Nations player to play in the NBA in over, what, 30 years?
30 years, yeah. Representing all of Canada, all of Alaska.
Yeah. And right now the youth are out there dancing. That crowd showing their appreciation.
I don't think there's one person in here not smiling.
Yeah.
I'm looking around. I honestly can't see anybody not smiling.
Yeah.
It's great.
They like the one in the mask that's on the far side.
<It's a laughs> cute kid. Amazing.
I think he won all their hearts.
Oh. So awesome to see the young kids out there practicing our culture. Oh, he's going for a solo.
Yeah.
It's beautiful. Somebody get that kid a Twitter account. He's amazing. Birthday today.
Thank you, Shayla. Really quick, happy birthday.
Well, happy birthday, Shayla. The whole house singing young Shayla, happy birthday.
All the men in our audience to come down and share a little bit in our song. This is our men's challenge. And the reason that we have the song is my grandmother, Laura Smith, told me one day you're going to go find a husband. Make sure he's tall and strong and can ride for you in the winter. So over there, we'll have the killer whales, the wolves over there, eagles over here, and the Dunhada. So
I go to there.
I think Nathan and our mayor can get you guys.
I'm an eagle. I'm going to go to the far corner.
I knew Jennifer Rice went up there for the men. Tomboy.
Hey, she wants the challenge. Let her challenge.
So, it's a
she could fight for Nathan.
So you if you guys clap loud enough, the men go lower to the ground. So we'll see how low they can go. school. This is the men's challenge.
We got the mayor of Prince Rupert out there.
Yeah, and Nathan Collins, our MP.
Great representation from the men.
Well, I'd say the mayor of Prince Rupert got broken in tonight.
I'll second that. If you want to come dance, you have to go and grab her and bring her down, and if she refuses you, you have to pay. She has to pay you $20. So we're going to do the same thing. We're going to go.
Well, now it's the lady's turn.
Over there. Eagles over there, killer whales over here, and the wolves over here. We'll invite everybody, all the ladies in the audience, please come and join us. That's your plan.
When, if anybody comes towards us, we'll just pretend to be talking on the air all the time.
I think they can only grab the ladies. That's why our sales staff, Yolanda Layton, came to hide behind us. But I think I'll do a good job at pointing her out.
We'll point her out.
We're pointing her out. Because if you deny to go up and dance, it's going to cost you $20.
Yeah. Either that, she can pay us 20, and then we wouldn't have to tell her where she is.
10 each. Subway. Eat fresh.
Thank you.
up the vice president of the All-Native Committee, Eva Spencer, Hall of Famer, inducted last year. The dance group with $5,000.
That's a pretty good gesture, considering they probably pulled in $20,000 tonight. But it's expensive. I wonder how they traveled up here. Must be Van City sponsoring, because
she
usually gets a lot of Van City.
Yeah. thank you very much for the All Native Basketball Committee for selecting us. It's been an honor to be here and be with our people, and we thank you very much for this donation. We're going to go a long way. Thank you.
Well deserved.
Sorry, but I forgot to announce that at a later date we will announce who the opening dancers will be for next year. We will announce it at a later date. Thank you.
Probably during the induction.
So we will exit, and if I can call my Uncle Murray forward for a quick second to do a presentation.
Yeah, Friday night, City Eden Shop, 7:30.
And I can call forward, and the leader of the company.
7:30?
7:30, Friday night.
Everybody's still eyeing up the 50-50 draw time, which you're going to do any second.
Hello? Hello?
Too early for
Hello?
Me.
Seems to be quite a bit of tickets in the barrel.
A few moments, please. Watch it again. A few months ago, I had commissioned my niece Christine to do a song, the chief song that she did here today. And you see how well that they performed it. The dancers that just joined them, they had no problem at all singing that song. Christine, you know, you really do have a wonderful gift of composing songs and including the nation, of all people. I am so happy. I have never seen so many of our people sitting right here like this. All the nations that are there. You've done my heart so much good to see that. the unifying. You know, nothing unifies me better than traditional dancing and the all-native basketball tournament that goes on. Everybody comes out, everybody dresses, everybody raises funds. They do all kinds of things to come here and sit and watch. And I know it's been an honor for Christine and the group to be up here to dance for you, to show you. But just because they live in urban communities does not mean that they have forgotten their culture, that they haven't forgotten where they're from. They haven't forgotten their crest or their chiefs. They haven't forgotten that at all. So I'm really glad to see that. What I'm going to do is the song that I commissioned Christine to compose, I want to offer to Braden, John. Braden and John, Prince Rupert and Lafayette Labs, to use that song whenever you're going to do a chief's welcome wherever you are. I offer that song to you, and that song comes from the House of Elgin Catnall, so I offer to you to use it, you will. God bless you. Thank you. I hope you all had a good time. I'm glad everybody made it here safe and sound. I hope that you enjoy yourselves here at Rupert. You know what the song says? The song says, we're not here for a long time, we're here for a good time, right? Thank you.
Somebody, yes.
The winner is Taz Initials FM, and the winner gets $1,263.50 FM.
You should tell them to fill out the full name on there.
FM has just won $1,200.
One year we had two winners with the same initials.
They must have a phone number.
So we are now going to do the chief song, and I just wanted to thank the paddle song that you've seen us come in with is a song that comes from the House of Nice Use. They had given us permission to use it. I wrote it when Sheldon and I got married, and we put it into the House of Nice Use. So thank you very much for that. This is our song that we're going to do now is our chief song.
The Chiefs entered there. They're exiting with the Chiefs on.
Oh,
Well, Van City did not disappoint. What a great, great performance tonight.
That's right. Yeah.
So great to see.
One there in the white and black, she's the one that does the basketballs and sneakers.
Leanna Spence.
Must be the Vancouver contingent.
Yeah, all that's left out on the floor is the Vancouver dancers.
Yeah.
If any of you are just tuning in, this is the end of the opening ceremonies at the All-Native Basketball Tournament here in Prince Rupert, British Columbia, the Jim Sogoni Civic Center. It's the Lachine dancers from Vancouver, British Columbia. Predominantly Tsimshian, but a mix of all nations.
Pretty large group here. We start broadcasting at 8 o'clock tomorrow morning.
8 o'clock tomorrow morning.
Metlakatla,
Alaska versus Lac-O-Lams in the intermediate division. Going to be a fast-paced game early in the morning. I hope those boys are getting their rest. They got a battle ahead of them.
But don't forget tomorrow night, too, the Miskut Marching Band that went to the Grey Cup will be playing at the PAC Leicester Center tomorrow night at 6 p.m.